Well, hey, what's up, guys? Lucio Sharps here. Never so much crap to blow up. Literally. I said I would go to Dollar General today. And I did. I got an amp board. It's in here somewhere. Yep. This is the amp board. It's a brand new Craig speaker that just came out, I guess. But same old crappy speaker driver. We're gonna blow it. So there's too much to explain right now, so I'm just gonna explain them as we go. At 3, I have to clean up, and I have to stop the video and clean up. The rest will just finish tomorrow. But yeah, it's around 2 right now, so we got an hour. So here we got this speaker out of a very crappy speaker. Not sure what it was, but I have reason to believe it was a Venture. Doesn't matter, it's a piece of crap. And we're gonna go. Oh, wow. Looks like I forgot to bring a screwdriver out with me. At least we finished the speaker. Looks like that's what I'm going back in for, is a screwdriver. Why is it not allowing me to break through the cone? There we go. That's it. I'm gonna go back in for a screwdriver and I'll be back. Now here we have this Sony speaker. This is from a surround sound system. It looks like a giant TV speaker. It'd be kind of cool if it was too. It'd give us better sound and more loudness. That'd be a really nice TV speaker. Well, for a TV speaker. But in general, just cheap. But oh well. Ooh. Not too bad. Kind of weird how these have such large coils to them. It's in the pole piece. Another one out of the way. Alright, here you got an X-Rocker sub. That was better than I thought it would be. That's off, right? Okay. That was nice. Just for what it was. We can do better, right? But still, the best one so far. The coils in the pole piece. Alright, here we have this. This is out of a satellite speaker for a sound system. I'm not sure what it is, but the enclosure looked like it came from a Black Web 5.1 soundbar kind of system. Oh well. Doesn't matter. Whatever it is, it's crappy and it's going to die. That's why I didn't blow it on the amp. But cool. This is from a real crappy Sony center channel. The YouTube channel Doubleism has, I think that's how you pronounce his name, his channel name, has took it apart, these speakers, and What's Inside Free Speakers video. I watched it. But here we are actually blowing one up on a big boy on 20. I think he blew one on his amp. But here we go. Jeez, that was loud. And alright, show too. Wish these weren't so loud. Lock solid. See if we can get it out. Nope. Locked. Here we have this Optimus woofer for a satellite speaker. The tweeter I'd already blown on the ACS250 yesterday. Here's a woofer. Cool. Didn't think it'd do that, but it's still on fire. No, it's still on fire, actually. Come on. And that's the orange we got going. Alright. Sorry about that.
These Sony woofers are gonna be loud. I'm gonna cover my ears as best as I can. Should have brought some kind of hearing protection out. Wee. Not as loud as I thought it was. Thought it was gonna be.
Let's see, do we have a fireball? That's tough paper. Maybe I should have kept these. I mean, I don't know what I was gonna do with them, but spiders are even tougher. No wonder it didn't move very much and therefore wasn't loud. Plus, that coil is smaller than I thought it'd be as well. Come on, get out. That's all I can do for that one. Alright, let's do one at the enclosure. Da Vinci. White van scan. Garrett Claridge has done quite a few of these. He did the, he got a pair of Sutherland for that looks like these, and then same thing for the Bergmans. He did mention, the Da Vinci speakers of the White Van Scam. That'd be also under this name, and also Hoffman. These exact speakers will be under a lot of names. I have the Da Vinci's. I have the Da Vinci versions, though. It doesn't matter which brand of these you get, they're all going to be garbage. Don't get them at all. It'd also be appreciated you tell your friends about this too. So here's this speaker. It's kind of hard hooking it up. I hope I was able to get it to where it'll still do stuff. Don't know how loud this will be, so I'll be covering my ears as usual. Nope, I didn't hook it up correctly. I know it works. I know for a fact it works. Must have been my crappy connections. But then again, these terminals don't belong on these, especially in such a tight space, let alone. And Logan's back out. I don't want him seeing me. I'm sure y'all want to see him, but he's probably not even supposed to be out right now. I don't want him seeing me anyway. So we'll get back in a second here. Alright, Logan is back in the house. My stepdad's going to get my brother, and then they'll get here. But apparently my stepdad hasn't gotten my brother yet, so
They might not be here until another 30 minutes. So that's good news for us. I tightened the connections on that thing, and Logan seems to be gone, or at least out of sight. But let's just go ahead and do this. Jeez, why they gotta be so loud? Jesus, that scared me. But that was the cap. There's a cap for that tweeter. I'm not gonna even try that tweeter either. That's poly. Poly propylene. Finally able to get that plastic. Plastic crap, and it's smoky. But yeah. Alright, that tweeter's probably not gonna do anything, so I'm not gonna even try it. And the carnage. Yeah, that tweeter did something. The coil is in the pole piece. Alright, I'm gonna let this thing smoke out for a minute. I mean, I don't need to see it anyway, but here's something I know y'all want to see. This thing has been done burning for a few minutes now. So there's the carnage of that one. Cool. Alright, here are this Edifier speaker. I know it's high quality. Well, it's not really high quality. It's better than what I see in most speakers, but yeah, let's just go ahead and do it. I was gonna save it, but it doesn't have the wall mount I want, so. I felt the air from that, and it's on fire. Cool. Let's see while I get that tweeter going. Or a capacitor. No, it looks like it's done. Cool. Now some weird material for a woofer cone, especially for a woofer. There you go, once you come through the cone and the spider is still burning. Wee! Smoky. Wonder how his tweeter is doing for carnage. Cool. And going back in and burn. And I got ferro fluid. Sony in an enclosure. But yeah, that's what they look like. These are the Sony SS-MSP2. Jeez. And it's in the pole piece. Oh. Delco 6x9, 10 ohms. Meh. Two leads every time. Rotten paper. Cool. Alright, I'm done with free air drivers for right now. I'm trying to get all these
ones in the enclosures done. Here we got this vintage speaker. Let's hope this isn't zoomed out. Zoomed in. Microphone's been covered. Let's see what's under the grill. Just that little cheap piece of crap. I still want this grill off. It's ugly. Uh-oh. How's the driver? Enough to make it non-working, but still. Yeah, look at that cheap. Look at that cheap vintage. That now has a hole in it. Well, can you see it? Nope. Use a dead speaker to prop this one up. Okay, make sure wires aren't gonna get shorted. Where are you, wires? Now that should work. Gunshot. Quite a gunshot from a little speaker. No. The voice coil is stuck in the pull piece. I lost the former though. Cheap, cheap, cheap. Freaking idiots. Yeah, that's so bad. We blew it up yesterday, but still. Ow. Quit hurting me. Boy. Don't hurt me. Hey, that's real plywood, though. Isn't that rare? Should have kept those cabinets. Oh well. Here, this really crappy RCA. Got some. You had a passive radiator right here. I was kind of dumbfounded with that. That's the second speaker I bought with a passive radiator, not for a bass reflex, just to make it look like another driver was in it. Oh well, still cheap RCA. Here we go. Spoke a little too late, but still. Let's see what's inside. Oh, screw this. Okay. See? Cool. Piezo. You have the Sony, it's in the enclosure, it's gonna be even louder. But, oh well! I'm gonna wake up my cat. One strong cat. Felt the air from it though. Whew. That's some smoke flow. Alright, let's see what's inside one of these. Or inside this one. Oh my god, such premium bullcrap. Cool. It's kind of weird how that tweeter works, because the other one didn't. Oh well. Let's hook up this RCA. Kevlar my butt. But, yeah. Rubber rot and all. Alright, hooked up. Ready to fly. Cue! Nice. Jeez. Where's my screwdriver? No. But here you go. Alright, that's it for the enclosure ones.
this up. Yeah. No cracks.